In this video, you're going to learn how to create Anki flashcards using ChatGPT. Okay, so we're going to start by importing our dependencies. So essentially, I'm going to import OS to access the OpenAI API key in my environment as my environment variable. I'm going to import OpenAI, Clipboard to get the content from my Clipboard, and then JSON to save stuff as a JSON. Here's what we're going to do. First, we're going to set up an OpenAI API key. Then we're going to get the content from my clipboard. So here I'm getting the content from my clipboard. And the idea is I'm going to copy some text from whatever, from a paper, from a website, etc. And I'm going to run the script. And that's it. I'm going to copy some text, run the script. And when I run the script, it's going to access the content on my clipboard. And from there is going to create the Anki flashcards by sending a request to the ChatGPT API. So let's create a conversation with the ChatGPT. I'm going to set up the role for the system as a helpful assistant. Before, I had set up this as you're a helpful assistant that creates Anki flashcards, but I found that it had, just because of this little change in the system prompt, it had problem creating Anki flashcards in the format that I wanted. And then I'm going to set up the message for the user. And the message for the user is going to be something like create Anki flashcards with the following text using a format like question answer, which is the format that's more easily importable to Anki. And I'm going to give it the clipboard content. And that's it. That's the message. And now I can just set up the request to the API. So I'm just sending a request to the check completion class, accessing the create method, and then saying I'm specifying the model to GPT-4. I'm specifying the messages that I just defined in this variable here. I have the system message and the user message. The system message describing the behavior that I expect, and the user message describing what I want specifically. Right, that's my actual prompt. And then I'm going to set up the temperature to 0.7, which is like traditionally is a good number to set for these kinds of things. I'm going to set up the max tokens, and I'm going to save the answer from the model to a variable called generate flashcards. And from there, I'm going to save them to a file. And that's pretty much it. I actually didn't use JSON, so let's just remove this. And now let's test this out. So what we're going to do is I have a paper here, and I'm just going to copy the contents from, let's say, the beginning of this paper. Let's say this was a paper that I was studying and I already read, and now I want to kind of like, okay, so I want some information that's here, I want to save it, but I don't want to be creating each Anki flashcard, right? So I copied, so now let's check that I copied. Perfect, it's in my clipboard. So now I can just come here and run the script. So I'm gonna just run flashcards, ChatGPT, perfect. And now let's see the magic happen. So I ran the script, it takes like a few seconds to finish sending the request and getting the response. All right, perfect, so now I finished running, so I can access that file. And as you can see, it created the flashcards. So what is CAMEL? CAMEL stands for Communicative Agents for Mind Exploration. What is the goal of CAMEL? What is role-playing framework? What is inception prompting? All useful information that was present in the text. Now I can go to Anki. So I can go to Anki right here, and I can import those flashcards directly. You see, it created the flashcards front, back, everything is correct. And I can just click import, and now I have the flashcards to train, to access, and et cetera. So yeah, this approach is really cool. I really like this. I really like doing this because, you know, you can also do it directly with the ChatGPT demo, the ChatGPT website, which also works really well. But having it as a script that copies, I can just, you know, stop, not think about it too much, and just have it on my clipboard, and then just run the script, and I can automate the running of the script, so I can just do it with a few commands. And I have a bunch of Anki flashcards that usually would have taken me quite a few minutes to create. So if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time. Cheers.